Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will see what is two-dimensional array. So here I have opened online C compiler. So this is the inbuilt environment here, and I am writing my program here. So before this, we have seen how to declare the array, how to initialize the array, and how to display the elements of the single-dimensional array. In this lecture, we will see how to write two-dimensional array. So first of all, I am declaring a two-dimensional array. So the syntax is data type of an array. So suppose integer type of array is there. A is the name to the array, and you have to give two dimensions. First dimension will be for row, and second dimension will be for column. So I am having the array A, which is having data type integer, and two rows are there and two columns are there. So the total number of element inside this array will be 4 now. How it is? So two rows are there, two columns are there. So 2 into 2, 4 will be the number of elements that can be present onto the array A. So the number of element of array for A is 4 now. So this is the declaration of array. Suppose I want to initialize this array, so I can give values here also. A is equal to, or A of size is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are my elements of the array. Suppose you want to print these elements of the array, you have to write the printf statement. So before that, you have to write the for loop. So suppose I am taking integer I, j, these are the two variables to retrieve the array. Next is I have to write for loop to retrieve the array. So I is equal to 0, I less than 2, and I plus plus. So I is the for loop I am using to retrieve the rows, and inside that for, again I am writing one more for, that is j is equal to 0. J less than 2 and J plus plus. So this is the for loop used to retrieve the columns. So how many dimensional array you are having, that much for loops you have to use. I'm using two dimensional array. First dimension is row, second dimension is column. Here my rows are 2, columns are 2. Because of that, total 4 elements are present inside the array. And to retrieve this array, I have to use two for loops because I am using two-dimensional array. Now I can write here printf statement to print the elements from the array. Slash n percent d, as they are integer kind of numbers. So a of i j. So this is my program. If I'm running this program, so what the output will get, okay, I is less than 2 we have to write. Okay. Again, I have to run the program. For loop, we need to close it. Okay, see, these 4 elements are printed here. So this is one way to initialize the variable. We can initialize the variable by second method, that suppose I am declaring the array, and if I am writing the things like a of 0, 0 is equal to 1, a of 0, 1 is equal to 2, a of 1, 0 is equal to 3, and a of 1, 1 is equal to 4. to these four elements. So this is another way to initialize the variables from the array. So you can check here, 0, 0 is the position that 0th row and 0th column, my element is 1. For 0th row and first column, element is 2. For first row, 0th column, element will be 3. And for the first row and the first column, my element will be 4. Now run the program and check the output. See, again we are getting the same output as we are taking the element same. Right? So see, this is the second way to initialize the variable. One more way is there to initialize the variables. What initialization means? We are providing the value to the variables. So what we have to do before printing the variables, we have to take the value for the variables. So here I am pasting the same. And instead of writing printf, I am using scanf %d, and here we have to write address of object. Okay. So see what will be the output now. We have to enter the element. Suppose my first element is 23, second is 45, third is 34, and last one is 12. So these are my four elements. So we are getting the same elements as the output here. 23, 45, 34, and 12. So these are the elements inserted into the array, and we are printing the same elements into the array. So this is the two-dimensional array where I am writing data type of integer. A data type of array is integer. A is the name given to the array. 2 and 2, these are the sizes. Previously we are giving only one size because that was single dimensional array, but this is two dimensional array. For that we are giving the size 2 and 2. Total 4 elements will be there. I and j are the integer variables which we have taken to initialize the for loops or to retrieve the loops. Next one is scanf statement we have used to take the input from the user for the elements of the array. Now see, when the value of I is 0, j is 0, element of first element, whatever you inserted inside the array, will be saved at the position A of 0, 0. Now, compiler will go to this for loop, and as the condition is not false, j, value of j will be incremented. Now the j is 0, the j is 1, I is 0, j is 1. So the second position will be A of 0, 1. Next time this condition get false, compiler will go upside. Now the value of I is incremented by 1. So I is equal to 1, j is equal to 0. So whatever the value inserted third time will be stored at the position A of 1, 0. Next time again compiler will go here. Now the value of I will not change, the value of j will change. So value of I is 1, j is 1. So the fourth element you inserted will be stored on the A of 1th position. So these are the things where we can enter the elements for the variables. And these two for loops we have used to print the elements inserted into the array.